Hey guys, Carlos Romero here, and welcome back to another episode of Road Traveling. And we are setting out on a Saturday night, heading for Lancaster. We are returning to Lancaster from Reading. So anyways, enjoy the ride. In any moment now, the lights should be turning green.
Dice María que ella no está en la casa, que te llama mañana.
Alright, now. Alright, now we are turning left. Onto Broadcasting Road. We're now getting on US 222 southbound. Going towards Lancaster. Going back to Lancaster. Here we go. We're now getting on the freeway. US 222 south. US 422 and 222 south. Lancaster, Lebanon, and Reading. Exit there. Alright, there's the exit. US 222 south to US 222 south and 422 west. Lancaster and Lebanon. Exit. 3/4 mile. One quarters of a mile. And 422 west. I mean 422 eastbound. Going up, yeah. Running exits, follow 422 east. Road work. And there's US 222 south and 422 west. It's Lancaster and Lebanon. Previously, US 222 used to follow US 422 through this freeway. And then it got off at the interchange that is now for US 222 business. After completion of the central section of this freeway in 2004, US 222 business was extended and US 222 was rerouted to follow the western segment of this freeway, of the US 422 freeway. So yeah, that's pretty much how things are like now, are like this now. US 222 south and 422 west, Lancaster and Lebanon, and that's the intersection of Paper Mill Road. Paper Mill Road, exit here, and US 222 south, 422 west, Lancaster and Lebanon. Hill Road, exit 1/2 mile. It was 422 west, Lebanon and Penn Avenue east, and State Hill Road, exit here. There it is, State Hill Road, exit here. US 222 south and 422 west, Lancaster and Lebanon. But we are staying on US 222 south to go back home to Lancaster. There it is. US 222 south to US 422 business. Lancaster and Penn Avenue east. And there's US 422 west, Penn Avenue west, and Lebanon. But we are staying on US 222 south for Lancaster. There it is. US 422 misses Penn Avenue east, exit 1/4 mile. are now shifting to the right. 222 South, Lancaster and US 422 Business Penn Avenue East. But we're staying on US 422 South. 12. PA 724, Shillington and Sinking Spring. Exit 1 mile. Now we're curving to the right. This is the official curve. We're now entering the northern section of the US 222 freeway that connects from Reading to Lancaster. This northern section was completed in 2000. Construction on it started in 1998, at the end of 1998. There's PA 724, Sinking Spring and Shillington. And there's the overpasses of Wyomissing Boulevard and Jefferson Boulevard. That's Jefferson Boulevard. That's, Wyomissing Boulevard. PA 724, Sinking Spring and Shillington. But we are staying on, US 222 South to go back home to Lancaster. Anyways, we're now on the central section of the US 222 freeway. This was completed in November 2004, the central section of it. US 222 South. And there's the Mohnton exit. 1/2 mile. Mohnton exit there. And we're curving to the right as US 222 business ends here. US 222 business was extended to its current endpoint here. This is where US 222 business ends. And there's the on-ramp from US 222 Business South. And there's the exit from Mohnton. There it is, Mohnton. Exit there. And there's Gallagher'sville, exit 1 mile. Gallagher'sville, exit 1 mile, and the lane ends here. Lancaster Pike. Gallagher'sville, exit 1 mile. Exit 1/2 mile. Gallagher'sville. 272 South and PA 568 East. Now we're in Adamstown. PA 568 East and 272 South. Now we're in Adamstown. Exit 2 miles. To the left. PA 568 East to PA 272 South. Hours, Adamstown. Next right, Shoop's Grove. That's the only attraction, and there's no food and lodging there. We're now descending down. South of PA 568 East, Adamstown and Bowers. We're passing over it. We're passing over the interchange. A lamppost had fallen down here on the northbound side. We're now transitioning off the constructed freeway of US 222 that was constructed between 2003 and 2006. Overall, this project of US 222 to construct the freeway between Lancaster and Reading was done between 1998 and 2006. Took 8 years to complete the US 22 freeway from Reading to Lancaster. Ephrata, free, and Lancaster, 21. We're not that far away from Ephrata, but we are still a long way from Lancaster, which we will be approaching shortly. There it is. That's the exit for PA 76, Interstate 76. At PA Turnpike and to PA 272, Pennsylvania Turnpike in Denver. Not to be confused with Denver, Colorado. Denver and Colorado is far away. Anyways, there's left lane closed. The left lane is closed, mostly due to the rehabilitation on bridges on US 22 southbound. Adamstown. That's right. Alright, and we're passing over PA 897, Dry Tavern Road with no interchange. There's no interchange for PA 897. Interstate 76. PA Turnpike and 272 PA Turnpike in Denver. If there's PA Turnpike Shield, if there's a PA Turnpike Shield, why do they have to put PA Turnpike as a control destination? They can put in, like, Philadelphia or... Yeah. Yeah. Alright, and attraction. Okay. Lodging, that's right. Redroof Inn and Comfort Inn. Gas, that's right. Turkey Hill. And gas, that's right. I mean, yeah, food, that's right. Dunkin' Donuts and whatever. Anyways, we're gonna be crossing over the PA Turnpike. Here it is. We're gonna be crossing over it. Interstate 76 and PA Turnpike and 2 PA 272 Pennsylvania Turnpike and Denver. They replace these with new energy saving lights. And a street lamp fell down here, but you can't see it. Anyways, we're passing over the road connector linking to the Pennsylvania Turnpike. Alright. Now, here kicks in the road work. This is where the road work kicks in. Left lane closed. Here, the left lane is closed. We need to be prepared to stop. We're going to get into the right lane. Road work. Turn on headlights. This is similar to the PA-283 reconstruction. From the PA-230 and 341 Toll House Road to like the I-Spire interchange where Interstate 283, Eisenhower Boulevard, and like PA-283 intersect. And there are ramps leading to and from the Pennsylvania Turnpike. And that's at the reconstruction of the Highspire Interchange is at exit 247 of the Pennsylvania Turnpike, which we just crossed over. It's Harrisburg East, which means it's east of Harrisburg. Harrisburg West is with Interstate 83, which is for Harrisburg, York, and Baltimore. I have gotten road traveling videos of Baltimore and York in York County, but only one. I will do more soon, if I have the chance. Anyways, we're crossing over a bridge, and we're curving to the left as we know it. Alright, the left lane is closed up ahead. Left lane closed. All right. Here it is. This is the left lane that's closed up ahead. Alright. The left lane closes up ahead. There it is. There's the road work up ahead. Left lane's closed up ahead. And there's US 322, Everett. Exit 2 miles. There we go. We're now shifting to the right. There it is. Yep. The left lane is closed, and we're now in the work zone. This is mostly to rehabilitate the bridges. Alright, now that we're out of there, we're out of the rehabilitation of the bridges, but the construction is not over yet. The left southbound lane is still closed. US 322, Evana, exit 1 mile. Okay, and there's food next right, gas next right, Sheets, and Giants, and there's no lodging next right anymore. There's food next right, McDonald's, Sheets, Taco Bell, and two others. That was a cool lightning strike. And we're now curving to the left and approaching US 322. This is the route I used to get to the Everett Borough Tour. When I was doing the Everett Borough Tour, I took this route. That was back in early June 2018. Upon completion of middle school, I did that. US 322, Everett. I heard this interchange is supposed to be get reconfigured into a diverging diamond interchange soon. Oh. Lane shift ahead. There's a lane shift ahead. We need to go extremely slow through here. That was bumpy. Well, there's a lightning strike up ahead. Alright, we are now out of the work zone. And soon we will be coming into an interchange with PA 772, Brownstown and Rossville. Up ahead is the overpass for Miley Road. Anyways, there's Miley Road. Yep, there it is. PA 772, Brownstown and Robsville. I heard PA 772 also goes into Leola, and it ends at US 30. And Robsville goes to the west. Brownstown is just on the left. Akron and Linnets, next right. And we're curving to the left again. Just after the Pool Road overpass. Alright. PA 772. Brownstown and Robsville. PA 772. Brownstown and Robsville. Whoa, those are lightning strikes up ahead. Gas next right, Sheets, and food next right, Subway, and Sonic. Not Sonic the Hedgehog. Alright, there's PA 772, Brownstown and Robsville. PA 772, Brownstown and Robsville. There is an interchange with PA 772 on PA 283 East, except that it's Mount Joy and Mannheim. And Brownstown has a CTC. Has the Brownstown Courier Technology Center, and so does Mount Joy. Mount Joy has one too. I visited the Brownstown Courier Technology Center back in October 2017. And I visited the Mount Joy one last year. Anyways, we're now going to be intercepting PA 272, Oregon Pike. To 272, Oregon Pike, exit 2 miles. Anyways, we're going to be curving to the left, to the right. Alright, Stone Quarry Road. The last overpass was for Main Street, except that you guys can't read it. There's PA 272, Oregon Pike up ahead. PA 272, Oregon Pike. 1 mile. And there also used to be a sign that said, Fort Landis Valley Museum and Lancaster Bible College, but that's gone now. Shawn Road overpass up ahead. Yep. And now we're curving to the right again. PA 272, Oregon Pike. To 272, Oregon Pike. There's the underpass that connects with PA 272. And the road we just passed over is the road that connects PA 272 via the ramps that connect with US 222 northbound and southbound, including the southbound entrance and exit ramps and northbound entrance and exit ramps. And also, there is another lightning strike up ahead. There was a lightning strike. Yep, there it is. Hunt Circle Road. We're passing under Landis Valley Road, and right there is the Calvary Church. Alright, and there's Landis Valley Road. Up ahead. But we're getting US 30 westbound. We're not getting, like, through the traditional way of, like, getting off of 222. We're gonna get off to the off of the 222 freeway by using Freddy Westbound. US 30 West. And 283 and 222 South toward Harrisburg. US 222 goes south from Lancaster to Willow Street, and then from Willow Street to Quarryville, and then from Quarryville to the Maryland state line. And then there's US 30 East, Cotisville, and Philadelphia. I did go to Philadelphia back in December 2018 when I was going to Atlantic City for the Christmas special. Anyways, there's the US 30 West, Lennox Pike, PA 501, and US 222 South, and Fruitville Pike. Right there was for US 30 East exits, which are four. Like PA 23 interchanges, like the Walnut Street and New Holland Avenue and Pike, but we're not getting those. US 30 West, 283 West and US 22 South, or Harrisburg. Anyways, we are now getting off there. We are now on US 30 westbound, but for a short time. Downtown Lancaster exits, Lennox Pike, PA 501, and South US 222, and Fruitville Pike. There's PA 283 West, Harrisburg, and US 30 West, York. But we are not getting any of those. We're getting neither. And historic downtown Lancaster used the Fruitville Pike exit. US 501 South and US 222 South, Lennox Pike and Fruitville Pike. US 222 South and PA 501, Lennox Pike and Fruitville Pike, and PA 272 North, Oregon Pike. Alright, we're now here. PA 501 North, Lennox Pike. PA 501 US 222 South, Lennox Pike at downtown Lancaster and point south. And US 30 and 283, US 30 West and 283 West, York, Harrisburg. The reason why I said point south is because US 222 goes south out of Lancaster. Anyways, there's US 30 West, York, and US 30 East and 283 West, Fruitville Pike, Philadelphia, and Harrisburg. It makes sense because, like, they cannot. It makes sense because you cannot turn directly from PA 501 South onto the Collector Distributor Road called Chester Road. You cannot do that. I wish you can, but never mind. It's not possible. Anyways, there's US south, Fruitville Pike, downtown Lancaster. Used to say Lancaster City at one time, before they changed it to downtown Lancaster. I'm thinking that Lancaster City and downtown Lancaster are the same thing. Anyways, we're now at the intersection of Fruitville Pike. We're in Lancaster now. We have just arrived in Lancaster. And we're now at the intersection of Fruitville Pike. So anyways, we are now getting on to Fruitville Pike. And we are gonna end here. We're gonna end at the intersection, or when we get from the intersection. When we get past the intersection, aka turning right, we're gonna end the video here. Alright, so now we are turning right. Alright, and now we are here at Red Rose Commons. Alright guys, that's gonna do it for today's road traveling video from Reading to Lancaster. Make sure to like, subscribe, share, and subscribe to turn on the notifications bell for all notifications so that you don't miss out on a future video / live stream to come. See you all later. Until next time.